Let's discuss about how to approach a case of hyponatremia. So, sodium less than 135 milliequivalent per liter. So, first of all, we have to evaluate whether hyperglycemia is present or not. Hyperglycemia. If there is hyperglycemia, then you have to calculate corrected serum sodium, okay? And I have discussed about this in another video. So you have to correct the sodium level, because there may be hyperglycemia induced hyponatremia as well, okay? And if there is no hyperglycemia and corrected serum sodium is low, okay, then you have to ask whether there could extra solutes be present in the serum. Is patient post-operative after post-prostate or uterine surgery? Has the patient received intravenous mannitol or intravenous immunoglobulin? If there is answer to these questions is yes, then you have to measure serum osmolality. Okay. So what questions I told you? Could extra solutes be present in serum? Is patient post-operative after prostate or uterine surgery? Uterine surgery, okay. And has the patient received intravenous mannitol? Has the patient received intravenous mannitol? Or IVIG? Okay. And if answer to these questions is yes, then measure serum osmolality, okay? Serum osmolality. And if it is osmolality is low, then low means less than 280 milliosmol per kg, then it is hypotonic hyponatremia. Hypotonic hyponatremia. And if osmolality is normal or high, then isoosmolar or hyperosmolar hyponatremia, okay? So isoosmolar or hyperosmolar hyponatremia, TURP and hysteroscopy can be associated with absorption of irrigation solutions like glycine, sorbitol, and this raises serum osmolality. And patients with suspected pseudo hyponatremia should have sodium measured by direct potentiometry. Okay, and if normal, then you have to measure total protein and lipids. Okay, so this is about on this side. Now let's talk on this side. So is there is a reason to suspect pseudo hyponatremia? And if questions all answer to these all question is no, then you have to ask another questions. What questions? Is there reason to suspect pseudo hyponatremia? So what are the causes of pseudo hyponatremia? Maybe due to hyperlipidemia, hyperproteinemia, okay? So is the serum lipemic? Is the patient jaundiced? Or is there history of plasma cell dyscrasia? If yes, then you have to measure serum osmolality. Okay. And if serum osmolality is low, then it is hypotonic hyponatremia. And if answer to these questions is no, or there is no pseudo hyponatremia, then it is hypotonic hyponatremia. And in that case, you have to see GFR. If GFR is impaired, then cause is renal failure. And if it is normal, then you have to check whether patient has used thiazide diuretics or not. If thiazide diuretic has been used, then stop thiazide diuretics. And if hyponatremia is resolved, then it is due to thiazide induced hyponatremia. And if it is not resolved, then you have to proceed further. And if there has been no thiazide diuretic use, देन यू हैव टू चेक वेदर देर इज इडीमा लाइक एसाइटिस. ओके सो इफ इट इज यस इडीमा इज प्रेजेंट देन इट इज ड्यू टू लो इफेक्टिव आर्टेरियल ब्लड वॉल्यूम. लो इफेक्टिव आर्टेरियल ब्लड वॉल्यूम मे बी हार्ट फेलियर सिरोसिस. ओके एंड इफ इट इज नो देन यू हैव टू चेक वेदर देर आर साइंस ऑफ हाइपोवोलेमिया लाइक लो ब्लड प्रेशर पोस्टरल हाइपोटेंशन. इफ देर आर साइंस ऑफ हाइपोवोलेमिया ओके इफ देर आर साइंस ऑफ हाइपोवोलेमिया देन मेजर यूरिन सोडियम. ओके एंड यू हैव टू सी यूरिन सोडियम एंड इफ इट इज लो आई मीन टू से दैट लेस देन 25 मिली इक्विवेलेंट पर लीटर देन इट इज हाइपोवोलेमिक हाइपोनेट्रेमिया मे बी ड्यू टू एक्स्ट्रा रेनल लॉसेज लाइक गैस्ट्रोइंटेस्टिनल लॉस थर्ड स्पेस लॉस यूज ऑफ डायरेटिक्स. ओके एंड इफ इट यूरिन सोडियम फॉल्स बिटवीन 25 to 40 मिली इक्विवेलेंट पर लीटर देन इनफ्यूज आइसोटोनिक सलाइन 1 liter over 1 hour and measure remeasure urine sodium. Okay, if serum sodium is 125 or less, we do not give isotonic saline. In such patient, the evaluation can be delayed until the sodium is slowly raised to higher levels. Okay, and if urine sodium is greater than 40, then हाइपोवोलेमिक हाइपोनेट्रेमिया रेनल लॉस. ओके सो रिव्यू हिस्ट्री एंड मेडिकेशंस एंड मेजर एएम कोर्टिसोल एंड एसीटीएच स्टिमुलेशन टेस्ट. ओके सो इफ देर इज लो कोर्टिसोल और पॉजिटिव एसीटीएच स्टिमुलेशन टेस्ट देन ऑब्वियसली कॉज इज प्राइमरी एड्रेनल इनसफिशिएंसी. And you also have to check whether there is patient has used any medications like diuretics because diuretic may also cause or patient has head injury or cranial surgery because cerebral salt wasting can also cause hyponatremia. Okay, and this is about if patient has low effective arterial blood volume. No, and if there is no sign of hypovolemia. No. If there is a low volume, then you have to measure urine sodium. No, there was a low volume hypovolemia, and you measured urine sodium, and we followed on this path. Okay, and if there is no signs of hypovolemia, this is about hypovolemia, and if let's say there is no hypovolemia, or there is normal volemia or hypervolemia, then how would you proceed? I mean to say that if you examine and you find normal blood pressure or there is no postural hypotension, then you have to measure urine sodium and urine osmolality. Okay, and urine osmolality, you have to see whether urine osmolality is less than 100 or not. If urine osmolality is less than 100, then urine osmolality measured after therapy initiated. Okay, urine osmolality measured after therapy initiated. You have to see again urine osmolality after therapy. Okay, and if it may recover in these cases like mild hypovolemia and patient is given isotonic fluid, or if in patient with hypopituitarism, if you give glucocorticoids. Okay, and if it does not recover or urine osmolality measured after therapy initiated, if it does not recover, then you have to check whether patient had consumed excess water, like there may be psychosis and can consume excess water, beer potomania, like those cases. Okay, so if it is about urine sodium less than 100, okay, and urine osmolality less than 100, okay, एंड इफ यूरिन ऑस्मोलिटी इज नॉट लेस देन 100 देन यू चेक यूरिन सोडियम इफ यूरिन सोडियम इज ग्रेटर देन 40 और नॉट इफ यूरिन सोडियम इज ग्रेटर देन 40 देन इवेल्युएट फॉर ग्लूकोकोर्टिकोइड डिफिशियंसी ACTH stimulation test and hypothyroidism and if all these are negative then SIDH may be the cause syndrome of inappropriate antidiuretic hormone but before telling whether it is SIDH you have to rule out glucocorticoid deficiency hypothyroidism okay you have to measure cortisol AM cortisol ACTH stimulation test TSH and if all these are negative then you can say it may be due to SIDH and if urine sodium is less than 40 then ensure that sodium intake greater than 150 in milliequivalent over next 24 hours so you can infuse 1 liter of isotonic saline over 1 or more hours okay if serum sodium is 125 or less we do not give isotonic saline In such patient, the evaluation can be delayed until sodium is slowly reached to higher levels. Okay. So, remeasure urine osmolality and sodium. Although patients with hyponatremia due to heart failure or cirrhosis usually have edema, that is clinically apparent. Hypovolemia may not always be apparent by clinical exam. Thus, in a patient who appears to be euvolemic but whose urine chemistries are consistent with hypovolemia infusion of isotonic saline can be helpful okay so you have to again remeasure urine osmolality and sodium and if urine sodium is less than 40 or urine osmolality is less than 100 then it is hypovolemic hyponatremia and let's say if urine sodium is greater than 40 and urine osmolality is greater than 100 then you have to evaluate for glucocorticoid deficiency hypothyroidism okay